So moms and dads, we were talking last video about this concept of dyskinesia, loss of normal motion in one or more areas of the spine as a result of either birth process or early traumas to the baby's cervical spine or other parts of the spine. We talk about this concept of disafferentation and think about it like this: input equals output. The spinal column and the spinal cord are always sending information up to the brain. When the proprioceptors are doing their job, they organize all of the sensory input as well as calm the brain, and they drive development of the prefrontal cortex, which then drives normal development of the motor systems, the sensory systems, the cognitive systems, personality, spatial awareness, motor planning, both fine and gross, all of the things that help us to become high-functioning, well-developed adults. When there's problems with input, okay, what this will do will create a level of background noise that will disrupt the child's perception enough where it will lead to anything ranging from sensory processing issues to issues with ADHD, ADD, because what ends up happening is the input from their brain is going to be changed critically. If they're not getting proprioception, then what they get is this stuff called nociception. Nociception is like background noise or like Metallica. It's a really critical concept because if a child's brain is getting nociception when it's supposed to get proprioception, moms and dads, you've been there. You know what this is like. You didn't realize it until right now. When you get a headache, okay, what you're experiencing is nociception at a really high volume. It's become pain. It's gone over the edge. But take a step back. Let's talk about what comes with a headache. When you have a headache, you also tend to be less focused. You tend to have shortened temperament. You tend to have an aroused sensory system. So things like lights, touches, sounds, all things that wouldn't normally cause your sensory system to be irritated will oftentimes cause you significant disturbance. You tend to have more difficulty focusing and paying attention. You tend to have more difficulty processing what's being said to you because you can't concentrate. And it's little things like that where you have these really important connection points, because that's your baby. If a child has things like that from the very beginning, then their brain is not perceiving the world correctly because there's background noise. And let's take it even a step further. For those of you moms and dads who get headaches and get nauseous, so when you think about that, right, you get a headache and get nauseous. Is the stomach or the problem, or is it a nerve problem? And if you're saying nerve problem, you're correct. Because it's not the stomach that's having the issue. It's the output from the brain stem to the stomach through a nerve called the vagus nerve, where it's dysfunctional. Because disafferent, abnormal input, equals diseferent, abnormal output. And that process causes things to come in abnormally, and then in turn how the body is regulated also is not the way that it should. And that can be seen in things like constipation. It can be reflux. It can be drainage issues from the ears. It can be a number of different challenges. But all of those things can then cascade and develop into bigger, more significant things like sensory processing issues, hyperactivity. It can lead to issues where the brain is so deprived of that normal motion from the spine, the child can't shut down. They're constant motion. They're stimming. You're seeing loss of focus. You're seeing connection issues. Because what's happening is you're starting to see this progression where the nerves are firing together and wiring together, and you're beginning to see this thing that we call a dysautonomia. I'm going to talk about that more in the next video, so make sure that you hang in, watch the next video, and I'll explain it in quite a bit more depth.